Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 4, featuring Humphrey Bogart, Shirley Temple, Eddie Rochester Anderson, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
House of Squibb presents Academy Award. Every week, Squibb brings you Hollywood's finest. The great picture plays, the great actors and actresses. Techniques and skills chosen from the honor roll of those who have won or been nominated for the famous Golden Oscar of the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences. And now, E.R. Squibb and Sons, manufacturing chemist to the medical profession since 1858, bring you the distinguished star, Mr. Humphrey Bogart, who, as Best Actor of the Year, was nominated for the 1943 Academy Award. You will also hear Miss Mary Astor, who won the 1941 Academy Award as Best Supporting Actress of the Year, and Sidney Greenstreet, who was nominated for the 1941 Academy Award as Best Supporting Actor. Tonight, Mr. Bogart, Miss Astor, and Mr. Greenstreet will play the famous roles they created for the screen in The Maltese Falcon, the thrilling mystery which was nominated as Best Production of the Year for the 1941 Academy Award.
My name is Spade, Sam Spade. License number 357896, issued for the Police Department of San Francisco. Occupation, private detective. Sometimes known as Private Eye. My files in the case of the Maltese Falcon are closed, but I've got the Maltese Falcon. I got it and some dough. My partner got murdered and a very slick chick went up for life. I'll tell you about it. This slick dame comes to see me one day, gives me a song and dance about her sister and a guy called Floyd Thursby. She wants to get her sister back before her mother and father get in from Hawaii. I put my partner, Miles Archer, on the case. At night, he gets murdered. And so does this guy, Thursby. I go around to the apartment where the dame is living, the one called Bridget O'Shaughnessy. She had something I seemed to go for.
Oh, Mr. Spade, come in.
I have come in.
Oh, yes, so you have. Mr. Spade, am I to blame for last night?
You warned us that Thursby was dangerous. Of course, you lied to us about your sister and all that, but that doesn't count. We didn't believe you.
Oh, help me, Mr. Spade. I need help so badly. I've no right to ask you, but I do ask you. Help me.
You won't need much of anybody's help. You're good. You're awful good. It's chiefly your eyes, I think, and that throb you get into your voice when you say things like, help me, Mr. Spade.
I deserve that. But, oh, the lie was in the way I said it, and not at all in what I said.
If I'm going to help you, I've got to have some sort of a line on your Floyd Thursby.
I met him in the Orient. We came here from Hong Kong last week.
Did he kill Archer?
Yes, certainly.
Picked a nice sort of playmate.
Only that sort could have helped me if he had been loyal.
How bad a hole are you actually in?
As bad as could be.
Physical danger?
Well, I'm not heroic. I don't think there's anything worse than death.
Then it's that.
It's that as surely as we're sitting here. Unless you help me.
Who killed Thursby? Your enemies or his?
I don't know. His, I suppose. I'm afraid. I don't know.
Who are these enemies?
Well, there's a small, dark man with white teeth and a smooth, dangerous, fat man.
Oh, this is hopeless. Well, how much money have you got?
I have about $500 left.
Give it to me. There's only 400 here.
I had to keep some to live on.
Okay. I'll be back as soon as I can. You needn't come to the door with me. I can let myself out. I went by the office then and found a dark little guy with very white teeth waiting for me. His name was Joel Cairo. He was a Greek.
Mr. Spade, I'm trying to recover an ornament that has been, shall we say, mislaid. I thought and hoped you could assist me.
Uh-huh.
The ornament is a statuette, the black figure of a bird. I'm prepared to pay the sum of $5,000 for its recovery, and no questions asked.
$5,000 is a lot of money. It's a very interesting figure.
You will put your hands together at the back of your neck, Mr. Spade.
Huh? Oh, sure.
I shall shoot you if you try to stop me, Mr. Spade. But I must search your office.
Well, you won't find anything but a pair of worn-out rubbers, a half pint of rum, and a pack of chewing gum.
We shall see. Please stand up. So.
Sure. This way?
No, the other way.
Sure. I'll take the gun, Mr. Cairo. Now get up.
I am very slow in things like that, unfortunately.
Yeah.
I'm still prepared to pay $5,000 for the return of the figure. Do you have it, Mr. Spade?
No.
If it is not here, why did you just risk serious injury to prevent my searching for it?
Well, I should sit around and let people come in and stick me up.
You wish some assurance of my sincerity? A retainer?
I might.
Say, $100?
You better make it $200. Thanks. Your first guess was that I had the bird. What's your second guess?
That you know where it is, or where you can get it.
Now, you're not hiring me to murder or do burglary, but to get back the figure in some lawful way. Say, from a dame with red hair, or a smooth, dangerous fat man.
Oh, so you know. You must beware of them. They would stop at nothing. May I have my pistol now?
Yeah, sure. I'd forgotten it.
Thank you. Now, Mr. Spade, you will kindly clasp your hands behind your neck.
What the?
Don't move, Mr. Spade. This time I might shoot. I insist on searching your office.
Sure. Go ahead. I finally got rid of the Greek and started back for Bridges' apartment. Matter of fact, I had a hunch that the Greek was going there himself and started to tail his cab when a sad-faced guy poked something into my back and said...
Come on. The fat man wants to see you. Here he is, Mr. Gutman. The guy who was talking to the dame in the Greek.
Ah, oh, Mr. Spade.
Mr. Gutman?
We begin well, sir. I distrust a man who talks too much.
I like to talk.
Of course, talking's something you can't do judiciously unless you keep in practice.
Yeah.
Now, sir, we'll talk if you like. And I'll tell you right out that I'm a man who likes talking to a man who likes to talk.
Swell. Will we talk about the blackbird?
You're the man for me, sir. No beating about the bush, right to the point. Let us talk about the blackbird by all means. Mr. Spade, have you any conception of how much money can be got for that blackbird?
No.
Well, sir, if I told you half, you'd call me a liar.
No, not even if I thought so. But you just tell me what it is, and I'll figure out the profits.
You mean you don't know what that bird is?
Well, I know what it's supposed to look like. I know the value in human life you people put on it.
So Shaughnessy didn't tell you what it is? And Cairo didn't either?
He offered me $10,000 for it.
$10,000? And dollars, mind you, not even pounds. They must know what it is. Or do they? What is your impression?
I can't tell. They're both lying.
If they don't know, I'm the only one in the whole wide, sweet world who does.
Swell. When you've told me, that'll make two of us.
Mathematically correct, sir. But I don't know for certain that I'm going to tell you.
Oh, don't be foolish. You know what it is, I know where it is. That's why I'm here.
Well, sir, where is it?
Don't be silly.
You see, I must tell you what I know, but you will not tell me what you know. That is hardly equitable, sir. No. I don't think we can do business along those lines.
Yeah, well, think again and think fast. I can get along without you, and keep that gunsel away from me while you're making up your mind. I'll kill him.
Well, sir, I must say you're the most violent temper.
Well, what are you wasting time for? You've got till 5:30. Then you're either in or out for keeps.
Three characters and a black bird. Well, all I knew was my partner was dead and the cops were getting very uncooperative about the whole thing, including who killed Floyd Thursby. I thought I'd better get back to see that O'Shaughnessy dame before it was too late. And sure enough, it almost was.
They came here and took him away.
Took who away? Who?
The police. They wanted to talk to you, too. They took Mr. Cairo with them.
What was he doing here?
He came to talk about the bird.
What is this bird, this falcon that everybody's all steamed up about?
Suppose I wouldn't tell you anything at all about it. What would you do? Something wild and unpredictable?
Maybe.
Well, it's a black figure, as you know.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.